Next, what we are going to see is conditions. What do you mean by conditions? This is again a very important concept, conditions. What do you mean by conditions? Can anyone tell me what you mean by conditions? Not we put the condition to our partner. What is the, what do you mean by condition?
Probably it's like if a particular condition, like if loop or loop, right? If one is satisfied or true, then the next thing happens.
Yes. Not the for loop. For loop is not a condition.
If.
Yes. If is a condition. Say for example, when you go into purchasing something, you say, if I don't get this, we'll go for this item. If you don't get this item, we'll go for that item. So that condition that you put is what we are going to do it in the script. Now, when do we use this condition? We use this condition when we want to check if a particular value is true or false. That's when we use the condition. What do you mean by that? That means that I'm going to say, if, say example, A is equal to 10. Now, I want to check whether A is really equal to 10. How do I check that? Now, when I'm checking it, I go and check once. Now, once I check, I have to perform an activity. So how do you write? Let's write a simple algorithm for this. For conditions, let's write a simple basic algorithm for conditions, right? Clean this up. I'm going to save. Conditions. Now, how do we write? First, I'm going to say A equal to 10. Now, I wanted to check whether A is equal to 10. So now, when I write my condition, I will say check whether A is equal to 10. In that case, if A is equal to 10, A is equal to 10, then do this. And if, that means and if is saying that this is completed. When you write an is, you have to write an end if. So you will say this is where the statement is completed. This is one way of checking, where I will check whether, just check one condition. I'm only checking one condition. I'm not saying, I'm checking whether, checking one condition. Say one condition. I'm not giving an option. That is, if A is not equal to 10, what should I do? No, I'm not giving this. Let's write this code and see. I'm going to say if, the moment I type if and a space, it will automatically create the format for you. Say A is equal to 10, then MSG box A. So now if I run this, it will print me A because A is already equal to 10. You see, it satisfied the condition. So it went in, it printed the value of A and then it completed. Now, this is called operators. We have multiple operators with us. If you see my site, if you go down to tools, VBScript, QTP VBScript, and go to operators, you will see all type of operators here. Now we have multiple type of operators. This is what we are going to do for arithmetic operators, where we just now saw equal to, where is that? Oh, sorry, comparison operators. We are going to see comparison operators now, where we just saw equal to. That means if a value is equal to 10, then do this activity. So this is single condition. single condition where I just check one value. If I say 10 equal a equal to 11, what will happen? I'm going to put a breakpoint here and run. I'm going to run it in debug mode. I'll teach you what it is. Don't worry. Now I stopped the script because I wanted to show you line by line how it is executing. Now what is the value of a here? The value of a is 11, right? So will this condition be satisfied?
No.
No. So it should go into the loop or should not go into the loop?
It shouldn't.
It shouldn't. You see, it didn't go into the loop and it didn't print. That is single condition. Now, if you want to say what should happen if A is not equal to 10, that is a second level of condition. Where I am going to say what should happen, should I do if is false? That is, if my A is false, what should I do? So let's copy this condition again. I'm going to paste it below this. And so if this condition is not true, I'll go into that and say else MSG box. Now if I want to, Shruti, can you help me out to type, I wanted to type in the message box the value of A is equal to this. How do I type that?
You open quotes.
Open quotes.
The value of A is.
The value of A is.
Close quotes. Ampersand.
No. Use the right term. What is it? What is the ampersand called?
Concatenation.
I'm not interested in the value. I'm interested in the terminology. Okay. Concatenation.
A.
A. Perfect. Let's run this and see. I'll take this and put it here. Let's run this. You see? It went into the else loop rather than the if loop because this condition is not satisfied. So it came here, it checked whether A is equal to 10. No, A is not equal to 10. So this condition became false. But I have said if this condition is false, do something else. So it printed me this.
You gave a quick question. So now after that A, so after print the value of A, if I want to attach another string, I just do concatenation and then open another quote.
Correct. Fine. Got it?
Yep.
Now let's see the next level, the third level of condition loops. Where I have multiple conditions. Where do we have these multiple conditions? Anyone can give me an example of a multiple condition where I have to check multiple conditions? Anyone can give me an example?
I have a lot of parameters like age, sex, like I have to satisfy like...
No, not like that. Not like that. You cannot do like that. I cannot check if my age is A and my sex is M.
No. If age is above 18, then only go into a particular thing.
Correct. That's correct. That's perfect. So I'll take a simple example. Say example, age only we will take. I'm going to say age equal to, I wanted to dynamically get an age value. How do I do that, Karthi?
input box, Rajesh, like, so.
Go on.
So input box and then open quotes.
Equal to. Input box.
Oh, and in quotes you can say enter. Quotes. I mean, in the parentheses you can say enter. Enter your age. Then close quotes. Close the parentheses.
Okay. Now, Dirtena, what will happen? Will my age be integer or a string?
It will be whatever you assign it, like it will be a string only.
But how do you check? I want it to be an integer.
You just put int outside input box and then put that in parentheses.
Int.
And then
okay. Fine. Now, I'm going to get the age from you. Okay. Now I want to check the condition. If, say, example, age is if my age is less than 40, less than 30. Okay, my age is less than. What am I typing? Less than. God, 30. Then. Print, what do we print?
Not eligible or something.
Okay, not. Not eligible for. Okay.
Not eligible for marriage, be happy.
No, not eligible for coffin. Then, if the age is. You have to say age is greater than 40. Less than 40, when 30 also comes less than 40, no?
Okay.
Greater than. Okay, this is. Okay. Now, greater than 40. Sorry, greater than 30 and less than 40. What do I print here?
Something funny, Rajesh.
Something funny? Mm-hmm. See, if I can't say not eligible for marriage because I got married at the age of 25. So, I don't know what to do with that. Okay. What to say?
Values, or I can say, you know.
Oh, what I should print?
Print is eligible for marriage.
30 to 40 vayasu paavu.
No, time is changing. It's not like, you know, we get married at 25.
So I didn't get married 15 years before at the age of 25. I got married in 2007. So the time is still the same only, not a long way through. Huh?
You can just print, go buy a car.
Okay. Go.
Actually, I was okay. Going to say, you know, if it's less than 30, you print, you know, you're still young. And
with
greater than 30,
friend,
okay, you know, you've crossed the bridge, say bye.
So, okay, you can't say at 40 and all, you can't say cross the bridge and say bye. Jump the bridge, right? What do you mean to say?
No, I mean cross the bridge, you've been young, so you've
gone to the other side. Okay, so that means you put one leg into the coffin.
Yep.
Okay, now greater than 40 and less than 50. Okay.
Oh, by a house, don't forget marriage.
Don't forget a house. Oh, sorry. Don't work. Greater than 50 and less than 60. You want to print? than 60 and less than 70.
Repair.
Okay. Greater than 70 and less than 80. Okay. Fine. We'll stop with this. So now I have multiple conditions to check, right? But only one variable that's going to come in, and based on the value that's coming into this variable, I have to check multiple conditions. Now, if I use this, I can check only two conditions. Now, how do I check multiple conditions? For this, what we do is, same, exactly the same what we were doing. So what we'll do, we'll go here, start with an if, check for the first condition. If it is true, then get in. Then what we did to check if this condition is false, check for the second condition, right? Now here we did not give any condition. If this true, false, else, go into this and print this. This is what we were doing. Now, if I wanted to check the second condition, that is, if the first condition is true, check whether the second condition is true. So how do we do? For that, what we are going to do, we are going to write else if, and now I can put the same condition here, second condition here. Then go in. If this condition is not true, again, I can put else if. Now, using else if, I can keep going. So, I will put one if, then I will use else if n number of times, and then I can use, at the last, I can use else. That means, if all these conditions doesn't satisfy, then do this. Guys, you are able to understand this? Guys, Nasir?
Yes, yes, sir.
You are able to understand this?
Yes, I understand that.
Okay. Now, let's go one at a time. So, how do we write these conditions? I'm going to say if. Now, we need the operators, right? Conditional operators. What are the conditional operators that we have? If you see here, let's see the conditional operators. We used equal to. Then we have greater than, we have less than equal to, greater than equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to. So these are conditional operators that we can use, as well as you have logical operators, that is and, or not. So these two conditional operators, these comparison operators and logical operators, we can combine to get our activities completed. So if you look at this, we might have to use the conditional and logical operator. So let's see. If I'm going to start with first one, if age, age is, I'm going to say, should I say equal to 30, or what conditional operator should I use here?
Less than 30.
That's it?
Yes, less than
30. No, not less than 30. Let's see. Anyone else? Because if I use less than 30, if my age is 30, it will not go inside that loop, right? Yes. Yes, Harshit. Correct. It is less than or equal to. You see here, this condition. You know why we are using this, Nasir?
Yes.
Why we are using this?
Yeah, less than 30 or greater.
No, less than 30 or equal to 30.
Yeah.
So what is my condition here? If his age is less than 30, he's not eligible for marriage.
Yes.
But the next one is greater than 30. So greater than 30 is 31.
Yep.
Less than 30 is 29. Now, what about 30?
Equal.
So I will say greater, less than or equal to 30. Then say, now here I wanted to, okay, we'll do the print later. So we'll say message box. Message box, I want to say not eligible for marriage. Not eligible for marriage. Okay. Now the next condition, how do I write? I want to check the next condition. I will say else if. Again, I'll say, now I have to check two things. Greater, the value of A should be greater than 30 and the value of A should be less than 30. Now, what we have to do? Can anyone help me out how we can do that?
This
greater
than 30.
Greater than 30.
And
what is this operator called?
Is the comparison of
It's the logical operator, right?
Logical.
Now you are using the logical operator.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
What else? And
we want up to 40. So less than or equal to 40.
Age
less than
or equal to 40.
Message box.
We don't need a then.
Oh, okay. We don't need
a then. Only for if we need a then.
Oh, okay. What else is going
on? Else?
Mm-hmm. Then go buy a car. We have to say go buy a car there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. Now, thanks. Can you give me the next one?
Okay, greater than 40. So, else if age greater than equal to, should be greater than,
yes,
40.
40?
You already had equal to above.
Yep.
What's that? Less than 50 or less than or equal to 50.
Perfect. Then I go into this loop.
And add go buy a house, forget marriage.
Okay. So similarly, I'm going to copy paste the next one. So I can create n number of conditions like this. I can check n number of conditions. So I will say here 50. And 70. Okay, so now the age that I'm going to enter, as soon as I enter the age, let's print that age, whatever we enter, and then we will. So age. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to enter a value here that's going to be considered as my age, and then it's going to come here first. It's going to come here. Check whether the value is greater than or less than equal to 70. Did not have 70 and 60. Oh, okay. Okay, let me save this. Okay. Oh, okay. I have to put it in this. Sorry, guys. Okay. Now let me save this. Fine. Now let me run this in debug mode. I'm going to run this in debug mode. I'm going to hit run. Run from this tab.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me an age.
25.
What?
32.
Actually, solunga. Correct age.
This is not right. I'm a woman.
But you can ask what the man's salary openly, but you can't tell the age. No. Okay. So, okay. 30.
Yes, really, I'm 25.
Oh, okay. That's feeling young. Fine. Now I'm saying 32. Now 32 is the age that we are going to validate. Now I'm going to run here. Now it is going to come to the first thing. Now the age is, if you see down where my mouse is, you see here the age is considered as 32. Now in 32, will this condition satisfy? This condition will not satisfy. So it will not go into this loop. Done. See, this condition did not satisfy. Will this condition satisfy? Age should be greater than 30. Now, since we used and, what does this mean? This condition should be satisfied as well as this condition should be satisfied. That's when it will go in. When you use an and, both conditions should be satisfied. So, is your age greater than 32? Yes. Is your age less than 40 or equal to 40? Yes. Now it will go into this loop. You see, it's gone into that loop and it will print me that. See, now it has printed me this. Now you see that once it finds one condition is satisfied, the moment I click OK, it will come out of the loop. See, it is out of the loop.
Why did it stop like after the...
Yeah, the condition got satisfied, right?
The first one, right?
Not the first one. The second condition got satisfied, right? This
yes.
condition.
Yes.
So once you get into the condition and one of the condition gets satisfied, it will come out. It will execute that code and it will come out of the loop.
Okay, but what if I have to go till the end?
No, it won't go. So you want to go till the end, then you have to put the age as 75. That's when it will go till the end.
Oh, initially where you put the age as 32.
Yes, instead of we putting the age as 32, if I put the age as 75, it will go till the end to check the conditions.
Oh, okay, understood.
Right. Yeah. Now what's happening? Let's run this. That condition is not satisfied. This condition is not seen. It's going and checking
yes.
each and every condition. Now this condition will be satisfied. See? It's gone into the loop. Now it will print that.
Okay.
Fine.
Yes, understood. Thank you.
Any other questions, guys? Any other questions? Fine. So these are the conditions. Now you to read more about this, you need to read operators as well as you have conditions, conditional statements. So this will explain about if else and if else conditions and what all this information that you have. It will give you a complete information about the conditions. Okay. So everything is written there. So you need to read operators as well as conditions.
Rajesh, how do we use this in our QTP, like in our testing career?
Testing career, what happens is, say example, when you are writing the script, you might have to print something into your Excel sheet as output.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So if you might have to say, or say example, you want to validate something.
Mm-hmm.
When we are writing the QTP scripts, right, we will be using mm-hmm. the safe condition. Say for example, one of the scenario that we will be working in our QTP is when we go here, then log into this application.
Right.
Huh?
Now you see this flight button is disabled. You see this?
Yeah.
Now in order for the flight button to enable, I have to enter this as well as this for this to enable.
Okay.
How do I check whether this particular flight button is enabled or disabled?
Oh, okay.
So what we'll do, we'll go take the property value and put it in an if condition. If this is true.
Okay.
We'll now log in. When we logged in, say example, there is an error that comes up. Say like what we just know we did. I logged in.
The password was wrong.
Yeah, the password was wrong. So I did Rajesh's username. The password is wrong. And I click on OK. You get this box.
Right.
That means the password is wrong, right?
Mm-hmm.
If I get this message,
then
what I will do, I'll go click on OK, do a condition here, give another password and click on OK to continue it.
Oh, okay. Until
I can do all those, until it's the right password.
Okay.
I can check those values and continue with the script. For those things, you need to check, right, something. For that, we will be using these conditions.
Okay. So we should know for which situation we have to do what statements, right?
So the situation is very simple. When you say you want to check something. You want to check whether the password is correct. When you talk about checking something, immediately it's the condition loop.
Based on the password condition that it has to be this much characters and the special characters should be there, those will mention in the condition, if condition? Is it like
No. We're not going to do that. What I'm saying is, see, this information that you are passing is you are typing now. In our future classes, we are going to see something called data table. This is an Excel sheet. We are going to put the values here and ask the script to take it from here. So the username that you are providing will come from here. If the password is wrong or the username sometimes gets deleted from the system. What will happen? The script will run like this. Click OK. And it's expecting this. It's not expecting the screen. Now the script will stop here. And it will fail. Now you are running it overnight. So if it fails, what will happen? The script will still stop. So you will handle this condition saying, if my password is wrong, if I get this screen, click OK.
Click OK.
And go to the next row and take that password. So those times, you, in order to handle that, you will be writing your conditions.
So this comes under the descriptive programming, sir.
Which one?
The program that we do now, the script that we write now.
This one. Like this.
This VB scripting,
No. This is normal VB script. And yesterday, what you wrote for homework, right? That is normal VB, normal QTP scripting. The script program is, you will not use, you use the object repository to capture the objects, right?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Descriptive programming, we will not use the object repository. We will write what the object repository will write. That's a different type of programming language. Okay, you're getting me?
Yeah, I got it.
Any other questions, guys? Any other questions? Fine. Now you all understood what are the three types of if conditions that we can write. The single condition, checking multiple, two conditions and checking multiple conditions. These are the three different types of if conditions that we can write.
Okay. Can you scroll a little bit? Okay, in the second level, can you go to second level? So if you say A is equal to 10, and if A is not equal to, sorry, A is equal to 11, and if A is not equal to 10, then message box A. So this message box A is the value 10 or value 11?
Value 10, 11. See, what is the value of A?
It's 11.
11. Okay. Now, if you put it inside the condition and say A equal to 10, it's not going to assign A 10 into A.
Okay.
It's going to check whether A is equal to 10.
Okay.
Okay. You got confused that if you put A equal to 10, then it's going to change the value of A from 11 to 10. No, that's not going to happen.
Okay. So it says then message box A. So what does that?
Then message box A means that it's going to print if A is equal to 10. I'm checking if value of A 10.
Okay.
Now the value of A is 11, right, Arshan?
Yes.
Now I'm saying if value of A is 10, then go and do this. If it is not 10, do this.
But why are we doing this? Like then, I think why are we writing as then message box A?
That's how this code is written.
Okay.
So if I'm saying I'm checking here whether what is the value of what value I want A to be.
Okay.
If A is 10, then you say then. What if A is equal to 10? What it should do? You have to write here, right?
Okay. So why is it message box A then? Why is it appearing as message box 11?
I typed it as message box A, right?
Yes.
But it will not appear message box as 11. No. If I run this code, let me run this code. We'll put a stop point here also. So I run this code. Okay. Now it's saying A is 11. If you see the value of A, it's taken the value of A as 11. Okay. Now okay. Here it is coming and checking if A is equal to 10. Is A is equal to 10?
No, it's 11.
11, right? So this condition is not satisfied.
Okay.
If this condition is not satisfied, it will not go inside. Now, this is where you should understand. Right? Now, here, let me clean this up. When this condition is satisfied, that's when it will go into this. In most of the programming language, we write if A is equal to 10, and then we put an open bracket here and a close bracket here. That means if this condition is satisfied, go into this.
Okay.
Else, open and a close. This is how we write in most of the languages.
Okay.
Here, that bracket is not there. We just put an enter symbol. Enter.
Okay.
So if this condition is not satisfied, it will not go to the next line. It will go out of this if and go into the else.
Okay.
Are you getting me?
Yeah, a little bit.
Akshay, in say example, in any programming language other than VBScript, we write A is equal to 10. If A is equal to 10, open bracket, close bracket. Okay, open braces, close braces, else, open braces and close braces. So now we can understand if A is equal to 11, this condition is not satisfied, correct?
Yes.
So it will not go into the if loop only. It will skip the if loop and go into the else. Because you have an else here, correct?
Okay, so it will put a different value.
Why should it put a different value?
No, else.
Where is the different value? Why are you thinking it's going to put a different value? A is equal to 11, right?
Yes.
A is equal to 11. Why is it going to put a different value to A? Where are you getting the different value? You tell me, Arshad.
No, I mean the next thing is else. So
next thing is else. Now else, since we are not putting any condition here, if this condition is not satisfied, do whatever is there in the else. That's what it means here. Okay. If you want to put a condition, then you have to use else if to put a condition here.
Yes.
If you put else, that means there is no condition. What if this condition doesn't satisfy, whatever is inside else, print it. Okay. That's what it means. So now to me, looking at this, my value of A is equal to 11. I here I'm checking whether my A is 10. Is A is equal to 10?
No.
No, right?
Yeah.
So this whole if condition itself is false.
Okay.
Now what else it has? It has an else here. Here we did not put else, right?
Yes.
Here I put an else. So that means if this condition, whole condition is false, do this work.
Okay.
Then if you want to check multiple, then you have to put an else if.
Okay.
You didn't understand? I can give you another example.
No, I understand. I understand now. Thank you.
Okay.
Can we go to the third one? Third level. There, Rajesh, if I had to just give an else, where would I fit that in? I see all else if, else if, else if. Yeah. Okay. So it's beyond the
okay. So now if I run this and I give a value 85. Now it's going to print the age. 85. Now it's coming in and going to check this condition, right?
Yeah.
We're going to check this condition. That condition is not true.
Yes.
This condition is not true. 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 So where it has to go?
Else.
Now it will go into the else. You see, it went into the else because none of the condition is not true. If I don't give else, it should have come out of the loop only. Since I gave else, it's going to print me the else.
Okay. Thank you.
You got it?
Yeah.